I'm Susan Norton with University Sustainability Practices, and we're at the ASU Polytechnic Community Garden today. This is a space out here for students, staff, and faculty to engage and learn about organic gardening. So in addition to learning how to garden in the Sonoran Desert, we also do composting. Some of the items that you can put into compost would either be green items or brown items. When we're talking about greens, that usually means a nitrogen source, and that would be anything that's living. So green waste from your kitchen, potato peels, carrot tops, things like that. Also any kind of green waste from your garden. Browns would be considered anything that is non-living. So that could be wood chips, twigs, bark, paper bags, cardboard, things like that. When it comes to composting, you usually need equal parts of each, especially in the desert where it's a dry climate. So you want to layer equal greens to equal browns, add water, turn, and that's how you get the decomposition activated. So now we're going to take our ingredients that we need for the compost pile to the pile, and we're going to incorporate and mix. The next step to starting your compost pile would be layering your greens and browns. So that's what the students have been doing out here. We had a layer of our green waste, then we added twigs, our newspaper, some cardboard, and mixed it up a little bit, and then added another layer again of green, browns, and continue doing that. When we mix both layers together, we need to add water as well. It's an important component to the decomposition process. So we need air and water. You want the moisture in the compost pile to kind of be or feel like a wrung out sponge. And that sort of helps to jumpstart your compost and actually produce your compost quicker. Compost can usually be ready to use anywhere from 2 months to within 3 months. And that's as long as you've actually made sure that the pieces of compost that you put into your pile are actually small. So this is our garden. We've had a lot of success over the years engaging students, staff, and faculty in teaching them how to garden organically. I'm excited to announce as we near Earth Day that we'll be opening our new garden, which will be more centrally located. This will be more of a themed area with a garden and interdisciplinary spaces where we can educate our students in a greater capacity with new programming, new event space, and new activities. We hope you'll stop by.